Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitta Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanang Bande Radhika Charano Dayam Gopi Jano Samayuktam Bindavanam Manohar Vāñcha kalpataru vaśya kipa sindhu vivacho Patitānaṁ pāvunebhya vaiṣṇavebhyo namo namah Mukhaṁ karoti vācālaṁ paṅgum laṅghaiti giriṁ Yat kipātam aham bandhi paramānanda mādavam Bindāvi tulsidebhai piyāvi keshava sacha Shna Bhakti Padi Devi Sattva Vattvai Namo Nama Narayana Namaskritta Narum Chaiva Narottamam Devim Swarasvati Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Katho Padesha Gauriya Patrasya Prakasa Necha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagod Bharanyu Deyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishtaduham Tethas Padam Siva Virinchanutam Saranyam Vetatiham Panatopal Havad Diputam Bande Mahapurusate Charuna Ravindham Yat Pad Pallavanaka Chandamani Chataya Bisphurijita Kemapigabodushva Darshi Purna Nuragara Sasagara Saramurti Saradhikamai Kada Kipam Karush Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Adyaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Adyaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajānulambita bhujau kanukā budhātu Saṅkirtanai kapitaru kamalāyatākṣahu Vishāmbaru dijavaru yugadharmapālu Bande jagatpiyakaru karunā bhatāru Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura Surair Bandito Dibharupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavanurupe nasada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyamananga madapuharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavishanatham Vagisha Jasya Badane Lakshmir Jasya Chabakshashi Yasasthi Hidaya Sambhid Pam Nishinga Maham Bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Jasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarabhaguna istatra samasati swaraha haro abhakta shakuto mahadguna manorathena sato dhavato vahi Jasyasti bhagavati bhaktir akinchana sarabhaguna istatra samasati swaraha Haro abhakta shakuto mahadguna manorathin asato dhavato vahi. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, if I look this material world with a motive to get control over this material world, then this become a tight bondage for me. If I want to look this material world with a motive to get control over this material world, then this become a tight bondage for me. Actually, nobody like to be controlled by Guru Vaishnava. That is the main problem. Nobody wants to be controlled by Guru Vaishnava. They are controlled by their whimsical mind. We actually, Gauriya Vaishnava, want to be controlled by Guru Vaishnava. But bonded soul, they never want to be controlled by Guru Vaishnava. That is the main problem. That is why they are not getting any satisfaction in their life. Always restless condition of mind persist in their life. They cannot go out of this problem. Actually, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in front of Sudama Vipro, that Gurur Anugrahen Naiva Pumana Purna Prashantai. Gurur Anugrahen Naiva Pumana Purna Prashantai. When you can get full peace, in Kirtan, what do you do? In Kirtan, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Kirtan, Narottama Thakur, you know, Sarvasva tomar charane sopiya porechi tomaru ghare Tumi to Thakur tomaru kukuro baliya jano mare. This kirtan you should do. Also, Atmanivedan tuapade kori hainu param sukhi. Try to understand. Atmanivedan tuapade kori hainu param sukhi. Dukho dure gelo chintana rohilo chodike anando heri. You will have to do this kirtan and you will have to realize. Atmanivedan tuapade kori hainu param sukhi dukho dure gelo chintana rohilo chaudike anand heri. Chaudike anand, all around I see everything okay. Ananda, anandamayam jagat. When Atmanivedan tuapade kori, that's why Krishna speaking that gurur anugrahe naiva pumana purna prashantai. You can get transcendental bliss, totally rest, totally, you know, you can cut this restless condition. When you are going to submit 100% unto the lotus feet of Gurudev. If in bonded condition, if I like to deliver somebody, how it is possible? In bonded condition, if I like to deliver somebody, is it possible? That's why sometimes I am bound to speak, mind your own business. Mind your own business, you try to get busy with your bhajan. Don't try to look here and there. Srila Prabhupada used to give one example, very nice example. Like one horse when running through a busy street, city, then actually you can find coverings on the ears of the horse, so that he can only see the road, cannot see here and there. Because if going to see anything, then the horse become restless. That's why Prabhupada used to give this example, that always try to see your track shown by Guru Padma. Many times before I told that Prabhupada speaking, in your daily bhajan life, in every step, we must try to maintain the stream flow of Bhaktivinoda Dhara in our life. Prabhupada speaking, in our daily life, always and every time, we must try to maintain the flow of Bhaktivinoda Dhara inside our heart. Always, every time. In that case, we can understand what is Hari Bhajan. In that case, we can realize what is actually Hari Bhajan. Otherwise, we cannot understand. Prabhupada used to say, we'll have to maintain always a flow of Bhaktivinoda Dhara inside our heart all the time. So, without the mercy of Guru Padma, mercy means full mercy, not half mercy. Because according to your activities, you are getting mercy. Gurudev, Vaishnava, they have no partiality. According to your own activities, you are getting your result. Whom to blame? So why you are restless? One reason, simply one reason. Because still today, you cannot accept all the rules and regulations set by Guru Vaishnava. You want to maintain your own life. You want to preserve something of your personnel. Whereas in Bhajan Vinay, already Rupa Goswami Pada writing so many in Shastra, different place, that we will have to give everything, even through Chaitanya Leela, we know, I cannot preserve anything for me. Is it possible to lead life that way? Yes, possible. Those who are Guru Das, those who are the actual Guru Das, they can prove in front of you it is possible. They never expect any amount of money, property from Gurudev. But I fear. Because I have Annabhilas, I have dual conception. That's why I am going to fear. If I am going to lose my bank balance, Hare Maharaj, I was bound to go away to Vrindavan without any penny from Guru Maharaj. But of course, Guru Maharaj gone. So it is possible. I never wanted to get any property from Guru Maharaj, never wanted to get even a single penny from Guru Maharaj, but I fear. Why you are feeling weak? Do you know the reason for why you are feeling weak? You cannot get stamina, stability, why, you know? Because you are going to ignore the vital point, labdharpanam. Whatever come in my life, I wanted to offer to Guru Padma. Labdharpanam. Even if you go through Upanishad there, you can find everything. That brahmachari, sannyasi should get everything unto a lotus feet of Guru Padma. Everything. And those who are grihastha devotees, they should mentally offer everything. They should not have any attachment for. That is the main point for why we are having dual conception. We are not established in Adhya Gyantattva. Labdharpanam, whatever come in my life, whatever pranami or anything, what you are giving, be sure it is totally offered to Guru Padma. If I think something, some enjoying mood, then I can become weak. I cannot speak Harikatha. That is the main problem. Labdharpanam, whatever we have in our life, why you are fearing? Bhayam dityo vinivishataha sat ishat apatasya viparjaya sriti tanmayaya ato buddho avayatvam bhaktaika esham gurudeva tatma. There is big explanation of this sloka. Bhayam dityo. I have some dual conception. I am not established in Adhyayan Tattva. That's why I am fearing what I can do, tension coming. Tension coming in my life, those who are pure devotees, you can find they are tensionless. They are like child. They are free of any tension. Because they give everything unto the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Nityananda. They are not going to fear any. That is why. The sloka I started with is very important. Jasyasti Bhagavati Bhaktir Akinchana. If you have at all Akinchana Bhakti, Akinchana Bhakti mean? Akinchana Bhakti mean? You have nothing in your life. You cannot deserve that this building is my building, this land is in my name, it is my. I am not going to lose my, you know, power here, lose my control. Follow what I say. One so-called devotee, Gyastha devotee, wanted to give a donation of one building to Srila Bhavan Goswami Maharaj. But after giving in donation, he is speaking, this room I can stay here, there nobody should enter here, and this bathroom should be reserved for me. Gradually, Bhavan Goswami Maharaj could realize they have no detachment. So, they Bhavan Goswami Maharaj give away the paper. You take your own building, I am not going to take for Guru Seva. Give away. This way, we will have to always realize a point. Why? Jasyasti Bhagavati Bhakti Akinchana. Bhagavati Bhakti Akinchana means there is no desire, no expectation, no future planning, nothing. All according to the desire of Guru Maharaj, all I can do. Really so, I am getting all different kind of help, all everything, divine help. Oh, automatically, I am not asking anything. Automatically, I am getting everything. How is possible? How it is possible to publish around 60 books without any penny? How it is possible? You cannot believe. Because you trust on, you know, bank balance, you trust on some influential people, personality, rich man. That is why in Bhagavatam it is written, why there those who are sannyasi, brahmachari, those in renounce order, why they are going to, you know, kasmat bhajanti dhamo durmadandhan. Kasmad bhajanti dhano durvadandhan, those who are blind, dhanomade vidyamate vaishnav nachine. Out of their money power, out of their educational power, they don't want to identify who is pure Vaishnava, who is not. Dhanomade vidyamate vaishnav nachine, they are blind, they cannot see. Follow. That's why in Bhagavatam, in second canto, it is written, those who are going to enter into renounce order, sannyasi, brahmachari, why they are going to depend upon kasmad bhajanti dhanadurmadandhan those who are blind out of their riches, they are andha yathandir upaniyamanam. That is the condition, that is why this is the poor condition of our society, spiritual society. This is the only reason. We cannot depend upon Sadguru. We cannot depend upon Nityananda Charan. We cannot depend upon. That is the main problem. So it is written, Jasasti Bhagavati Bhaktir Akinchana. Those who are having Akinchana Bhakti in their life, then all demigods, they are going to help him. But before starting your this kind of life, all, you know, demigods, they can kick you. All the time they can try to put you in trouble. Krishna speaking to Uddhav. Those who are going to enter into renounce order, all demigods, they like to put him in trouble all the time. When they find that this kind of guru bhakti is rare, and at the same time guru is sadguru, this kind of bhakti is rare, in that case they are going to give full cooperation to them. Not before that. Jasyasti Bhagavati Bhaktir Akinchana Sarva Gunois Tatra Samashati Suraha. Sarva Gunois Tatra Suraha. All, you know, transcendental qualities you can find in pure Guru Vaishnava. Sarva Gunois Tatra Samashati Samashati Suraha. All demigods can stay inside him, want to help him all the time. And harau abhakta sakuta mahatguna. Those who are not developing inside vision, those who are not going to develop their inside vision, they are looking outside. Oh, if this property is gone, how I can live? How I can manage my life? This is their conception. That why is they are always in tension. Always there is, you know, problem in their life. Haro abhaktasya kuto mahatguna. Those who are not the devotees of Supreme Lord, maybe he can put tilak mala. It's very cheap. You can buy tilak and mala and put. This is not the symptom. This is not the indication. So, you see, harau abhaktasya kuto mahatguna. Those who are non-devotees, maybe in the guise of devotees, tilak mala, saffron clothes, everything. Harau abhaktasya kuto mahatguna. Where is the possibility that they can have this kind of transcendental qualities in their life? Haru abhaktasya kuto mahatguna. Mahatguna means or high qualities, transcendental, vaikuntha guna. How we can expect in them? How we can expect? That is the main question. We are feeling disturbance, our mind is scattered, we cannot do Harinam with full attention, we cannot hear Harikatha with full attention, we cannot digest. What is the reason? Because full of tension. Full of tension. Prahladma already told to Nishingo, to actually Hiranyakashipu. So many times I discussed before. So you see, we cannot trust 100% in Guru Vaishnava. Somebody suggest me, some devotee, Maharaj, that you know, some Mayavadi is speaking nice philosophy. Follow. And he is speaking so nice philosophy and people going to die there. And how it is possible that whereas my own society, full of Mayavadi, as per Prabhupada, we are all more or less contaminated with Mayavad Siddhanta Vichar, feelings. So charity begins at home. Eh? I like to change you all fast. After that I can go and fight with him. In my own sampradaya, I find so many problems here. Charity begins at home. I cannot justify with myself, I am going for foreign preaching. It's a laughing stroke. All different kind of problems in the, you know, in your country, all, you know, mud, full of problem. And I am going for preaching in foreign country. It's a laughing stroke. So try to mind your own business, try to concentrate in your bhajan, try to eliminate all problems and doubts from your life. Then, if you can get stability, I can see, I have enough scope, I can do. Maybe they are also watching. If they like to fight with me, they can, but I have no time to fight with them. So let them speak what they like to speak, and there is also different kind of mixed population, those who are going to accept this, that. This vast market by Mayadevi. There is a so vast market set by Mayadevi, different kind of thing, item you can get according to your desire. Mayadevi decorating this material market in such a way, who is going to enjoy his life can get different kind of enjoyment, this, that. So what are we going to do? So, to attain perfection, our bhajan, what is the first step of our bhajan? Is to attain perfection. Perfection of our sense organ, mind, and, you know, body, everything. It's called perfection. First of all, we will have to attain perfection. Perfection means, you will have to go out of the influence of Maya. Can you do it? It's very easy. Many times I told before, you will have to go out of the influence of Maya. Sataraja Tamagun. Otherwise, you cannot start your actual bhajan. This is the first step you will have to do. That's why from Bhagavatam I told, Rajas tamascha satyena satyancha upasamena cha etat sarvam guru bhaktya purushohi anjasajayat. By exclusive devotion unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma, you can get this kind of facility. It is a very preliminary thing. Very preliminary. If you cannot go out of the influence of Mayadevi, how you can start a Aprakita Hari Bhajan that you don't understand? And if you take life after life, if your whole life after life, if I spend to fight with Maya, I cannot get, you know, I cannot get victory over Maya, then how I can start? Life after life, I am going to waste my time to fight with Maya. You think that if you can get victory over Maya, then you think you are successful. No, man. No. If you are out of the influence of Maya, that means it is a starting point. Prabhupada speaking, after Maya Jaya, after getting victory over Maya, what is your intention? What do you want to do? Because Mayavadi, they are also sometime preliminary, in preliminary stage, they can go out of Maya. After that, what is your resolution? Have you taken resolution to start Hari Bhajan? Prabhupada speaking. Maharaj, after getting victory over Maya, what is your conception? What do you want to do? That is the main issue. That is the main. Otherwise, again you can fall down. Arujja krichena param padam tataha patati adha anadrita jusmatangrayo. If I ignore the seva of Guru Charan, Vaishnav Charan, always I like to reserve something in my name, on my, you know, all everything. Hare, what I can do if, you know, big problem then, if I think that way. That's when I cannot believe unto the lotus feet of Anantadev. Who can maintain infinity world, infinity world, infinity world? He cannot give me two bread. Why, like beggar, you are going to beg in front of God? Oh God, give us our daily bread. In they are after reciting Bible, they are speaking this. Oh God, please provide us, give us our daily bread. Arey Maharaj, you are busy with bread, blood and flesh conception. One material poet, very famous, he is writing. He is a communist kavi. Follow, material kavi, material poet. He is writing. In my boyhood, I was bound to read it as a course of school. So there, now I find how foolish those masters are. They allow us to read. Purnimar chaand jodi hoy jhalsano ruchi ruti. You understand Bengali? You are learning Bengali. Still today you cannot enter. I remember the joking by Vidyasagar. Vidyasagar giving instruction to one Sai foreigner. You go and learn Bengali. After some days coming and speaking in front of Vidyasagar. Ami Bangla sikhe geche. Ami Bangla sikhe geche. I already learned Bengali. Vidyasagar Mazari, within the short period you learn Bengali? Yes, yes. Acha Sahib, you speak jal khawar khawar jal. Pine ka pani and nasta. Isme parthak kya? What is the difference? Jal khawar khawar jal. Jal khawar khawar jal. The foreigner, the Sahib speaking. Jal khawar khawar jal. Jal khawar khawar. Same thing. Sahib, you go. Try to learn. It's not so easy. Sanskrit, Bengali, language, so soft language. Not so easy. Go and learn. So, perfection, you try to understand, this perfection means, first of all, we will have to go out of the influence of Maya. Then we can start Hari Bhajan. Otherwise, Hari Bhajan is impossible. And we cannot believe unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. That is the main problem. If you are staying thousands of miles away from Guru Vaishnava, still they can give you kippa according to your mood. Surely you can get kippa. I can give some example from this material world. You know those tortoise, these tortoise are going to give birth some eggs. After giving birth, they quickly they cover up those eggs with mud, because that male tortoise can come and eat up. A female, the mother, is always she's anxious. She want to cover up with mud so that nobody can know where the egg is. Those eggs are. But that mother, I mean that tortoise, going to take the help of mental hatching. You can go mad. The mother doing mental hatching, always mentally giving hatching, mental hatching. Always giving mental hatching. After some days, when the time is almost going to be over, then she can find that tortoise, that all small, you know, babies coming. This way, if in this material world we can find this example, the mental hatching is successful. Why not possible? Why not possible in transcendental world? If you go on thinking about this Guru Padma also can give mental hatching, mean affection. Always continuous affection you can get. And you can feel. You need not run like a crazy man. You need not run. In your place you can feel that Guru Vaishnava is there with you. You can feel in your room, in your building. You can find, we as if that Guru Vaishnava is there with me. Sometimes you can also see. This is possible. So you should have full faith. You are going to make a network like a spider. Spider, you know. Spider always want to make a big network. You took birth alone. After that you grow. After that you become an adolescent stage. First boy stage, after that become young stage. After that you feel some, you know, some karma. After that you arrange some money, everything. That is your goal. Some education, some money. After that marry. After that you give birth some boys and girls. They also give birth to boys. This way you are making some big network. Whereas if you think very, very in cool brain, that your Atma, your spirit is always alone. You are always for infinity period, you are alone. But you are not alone. Paramatma, Supreme Lord is always there. Guru Vaishnava is always there, if you at all do bhajan. So, we are really alone. Because my father, mother, husband, nobody can go with me at the time of death. I will have to go away alone. So why not you feel that Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan is your only friends? You cannot feel. You want to depend upon these, that. That's why you are making a nice network. So this way you are going to put yourself in problem. You cannot take lesson about Bhagavad Dharma. Bhagavad Dharma is Atma Dharma, not so easy, but very easy. It's very easy, but yet it is very typical. Because if you are going to show submission unto lotus feet of Sadguru, then you can understand this point. Tasmad gurum prapadyeta jigyasu sevamuttamam sabde parecha nishnatam brahmani upasamasrayam. Tasmad gurum prapadyeta. So you will have to approach a Sadguru. That's why Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava wanted to give you light. Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava always want to show you light so that you can see your track, you can go ahead and nobody can cheat you. That is the main thing. Shabde parecha nishnatam means sometimes you can find somebody is very learned in this material world. People can say they are actually pandit, but they have no direct feeling about Hari Bhajan. But in this sloka it is written, Sabde parecha nishnatam brahmani uposamasrayam. So you will have to follow such a sadhu, such a guru, who is sabde parecha nishnatam, shabda brahma and para brahma. Para brahma means direct feeling you should have. Shabda brahma means shabda brahma, you know already. Shabde parecha nishnatam, nishnatam means words totally. Shabde parecha nishnatam, because if shabde parecha nishnatam, if you cannot give guidance properly, then big problem. You can express some doubt about Gurudev. Aray, Gurudev, I put question, cannot solve my problem. What is Gurudev? Where is the definition of Gurudev? Already I told you. I already told you, na? That any kind of doubts coming inside my heart, Guru Vaishnava can cut that doubt. That is the main duty. That is the main duty. So we must depend upon such a Sadguru who can guide us properly. Now, how to learn Bhagavad Dharma from Guru Vaishnava? Through Seva. Through Seva, you will have to dedicate your life, everything, unto the Lord Spirit Guru Vaishnava. Then through Seva, realization can come automatically in your life. When Vrindavan Das Thakur speaking, je tobe lathi maruta shirir upar Vrindavan Das Thakur, if so much argument I am giving, so much judgment from different scripture, still if they are not going to accept it, then I am going to provide a kick on their head. Then you can say, Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya is not at all Vaishnava. Otherwise, why is speaking this way? Why speaking this way? He can kick. He cannot understand the mood of Vrindavan Das Thakur. So it is written in Bhagavatam, how to learn Bhagavad Dharma? It is written, Tatro Bhagavatana Dharmana Shikshet Gurvatma Devata Amayaya Unubritva Jais Tushet Atma Atmado Harihi. How to follow this Bhagavad Dharma? How to learn? Gurudev, you will have to accept Gurudev at life and soul. Everything. Your life. Not that you have taken diksha from somebody, okay, no problem. Tatro Bhagavatana Dharmana Shikshet Gurumatma Devataha. From such a guru who is totally versed in Sabda Brahma Parabrahma, direct feeling of seva. And if you are inclined 100%, then Guru Vaishnava can inculcate his that direct feeling of seva. If he, Guru Maharaj, Guru Vaishnava cannot inculcate this feeling of seva, direct seva, then with which you can get busy in your bhajan life. Sometime you can sleep, sometime you can do some harinam according to your, you can run here and there, this we can do. Amayaya anubritva, amayaya mean without any maya. Amayaya, there should not be any maya, influence of maya, and anubritva, then you should follow the track of Guru Parampara, exact. Anubritta means there should not be any gapping. You are following Guru Padma, but I can find some gapping in. Sometime you are following, sometime not following. So there should not be continuous, you know, uninterrupted mood of seva. Amayaya anubritva. Anubritva means. Anubritta means uninterrupted vritti, heart of seva. Jais to set, by which Supreme Lord Himself become very satisfied. Many times I told, Naham ijja prajati bhyam tapaso uposamenova tushyam sarvabhutatma guru susso sayayatha. Krishna speaking. I become so satisfied, so satisfied, so satisfied, that I cannot explain you. True Guru Seva. I cannot explain how much satisfaction coming inside me. Jais tushyat atma atmado hari. So if Gurudev is satisfied, Vaishnava is satisfied, then automatically all your tension, anxiety can get vanished from your life. Unnecessarily you are feeling problem. So, why Mahaprabhu become angry with Vallabhacharya? Why Mahaprabhu was angry with Vallabhacharya? What can be the reason? He's a great devotee, Vallabhacharya. But Mahaprabhu was angry because he wanted to reserve some personal honor. He wanted to insult Guru Varga. Guru Varga mean? He wanted to insult, you know, Siddha Saipa. Sivasami wanted to insult Siddha Saipa. That's why Mahaprabhu was very angry. So when Mahaprabhu become very angry, when Mahaprabhu become very happy, you should understand from Guru Vaishnava. Personally, you cannot understand. Bhagavandat Acharya, you know, write one book, Satyaraj Khan. Write one book on Krishna, Sri Krishna Vijay. Mahaprabhu was so happy, so happy, so happy, I cannot speak. But it is in, not in Sanskrit, it is like poet, Bengali. Right. Sri Krishna Vijay. Mahaprabhu find one word there. Mahaprabhu, as Paramatma, sitting inside everybody. What is your mood? What is my mood? I am a cheater or not? I like to love you 100% or not? Genuinity is there. All Mahaprabhu can understand. Follow what I say. So Mahaprabhu was so happy, Mahaprabhu was bound to quote one word. Quote one word from that book. Nandanandan Krishna Mor Pranonath. Mahaprabhu speaking himself. He is writing one book. I find one very loveful, you know, word there, very full of devotion and love. Nandanandan Krishna Mor Pranonath. You know Pranonath mean? Your life and soul is that hero, Krishna. Nandanandan Krishna is more Pranonath. Pranonath. So Mahaprabhu speaking, I am just sold. I was bound to sell myself to them. Because they wanted to write this way. Nandanandan Krishna more Pranonath. This word when I come to know, I sell myself in the hand of Sutraj Khan. I was so happy. So now you understand the mood of Guru Vishnu and Bhagavan. Why they are not angry with some, you know, devotee? And why they become very angry? Is there any partiality, politics there? No. Mahaprabhu was very angry because he wanted to show, in fact, wanted to reserve his. He wanted to establish himself in front of Guru Vaishnava. That is the main disease at present. That is the main disease, more than corona. The big disease. Very critical disease. We want to establish in front of Guru Vaishnava. We want to establish ourselves. That is the main disease. Actually, Prabhupada can realize. Guru Varga all can realize. For what reason I have written this book? Why I am speaking Harikatha? Is my Harikatha for the total to seek the total satisfaction of Krishna? If my Harikatha is not going to satisfy Krishna and Guru Vaishnava, then it is not at all Harikatha. Simple thing you cannot understand. If your Harikatha is dedicated for Supreme Lord, your effort, you are trying to satisfy Supreme Lord. You are not going to give some entertainment, enjoyment to anybody. Only we want to seek the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord. Then this is Harikatha. Then it is Harikatha. Otherwise it is not Harikatha. You go to Vrindavan, so many speakers they are speaking. You can start dancing. You think it is Harikatha. A few days ago, some Jalandha devotee informed me, I am not going to take any information from anywhere. Directly from TV, this, that. So, he is informing Maharaj one's big bhakta, speaker. He is caught red-handed. Was so dangerous, corrupted. That is the main problem. We want to reserve some honor, position, money, property, everything for ourselves. That is why we are day by day we are feeling weak. If we can dedicate everything, then and there power can come in your life. That is the main disease, that we always want to get false honor. We always habituated to get false honor in our life. We feel satisfaction. It's the main disease. In our life, always we like to get some false honor. Not exact honor. That is why Vishva Vaishnava Rasuva wanted to arrange that exact honor exact honor, one exact devotee should get exact honor. Exact devotee should get exact honor. But we all always want to preserve or always want to get some false honor in our life. That is the main disease in our life. Follow, you see. That is why Mahaprabhu was very angry with Vallabhacharya. Though he is a big pandit, but still Mahaprabhu was very angry, very angry. He wanted to, you know, reserve some honor and, you know. But Siddha Swami Pad writing everything for the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord. Mahaprabhu can understand. And why Maharaj was very satisfied with Gunaraj Khan? Satyaraj Khan, Gunaraj Khan there. It is written by Gunaraj Khan actually, the book. So we are satisfied because Mahaprabhu could realize his heart. What nice, soft heart could realize devotion. That is why actually that day I was bound to speak, bound to explain that Ekalabbo was concentrating his mind, keeping the statue of Dronacharya, he was concentrating on something. And be sure your subconscious mind is so powerful. If you can master the subconscious mind, you can get anything and everything pertaining to this 14 world. So powerful. But that doesn't mean you have devotion. Follow what I say. If you concentrate on something, you know, though psychiatrists, they also test it. If somebody is going to concentrate on something, after 24 seconds, if you are successful for 24 seconds, then after that, if you are successful to maintain your, you know, concentration, then you can come out successful. This is the... So, Ekalabhya never wanted to satisfy Gurudev and get that, you know, Dhanur Vidya from Gurudev. He wanted to maintain some, you know, practicing, but it was not bhakti. But when Arjun going to do under the guidance of Dronacharya, he was successful, actually. So many people going to charge Dronacharya, himself, he says, you know, dangerous Acharya is going to, you know, take right hand thumb as a donation, done, so that he can play bow and arrow anymore in life, has some reason. Actually, according to Varnabang Ashram, everybody has some specific duty. Ekalabhya is from a low caste, according to his karma fall, he is taking bath. We are not going to hate, but anyway, according to his karma fall, he took birth. He should follow his own duty. He's from low caste. He wants to get this power what a Kshatriya should have. That is the main problem. If this kind of power, if one Shudra going to get the power of Brahman, it's not possible. That is why it is written strictly prohibited. They cannot touch Veda, Upanishad, no. Only they have the right to hear Bhagavatam. They can hear. Many documents there in Shastra. So Ekalabhya, if I want to do bhajan like Ekalabhya, if I am not going to follow my Gurudev, who is following Gurudev, who is not, how to realize, how to understand? Maharaj Prabhupada giving this example. Prabhupada giving this, you know, Siddhanta Vichar. If you find that all Siddhanta Vichar, all the power of Guru Vaishnava coming inside the heart of that devotee, in total, all Siddhanta is not, he never want to follow Sahaja method. Never. No compromise. If you find all the acharan, All the etiquette, achar, vichar, siddhanta, vichar, everything in applied form in the life upon disciple, upon Sadguru, Bishyo, he is actually Snigdha Shishyo. Snigdha means, no, in English I cannot translate this. If you translate, it looks like that. A sober disciple. But sober is not exact translation. Snigdha Shishyo means, who is totally Gurudeva Tatma. He who is going to get the place inside the heart of Gurudev as, you know, as the main star in the sky. Dubatara, North Star, you know. What do you say? I forget. See, Dhruvatara, he can make space inside the heart of Prabhupada and Guruji through his activities, through his dedication, devotion for Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. Then automatically he can get space, place inside the heart of Guru Vaishnava. You need not request. It's an automatic factor. It's an automatic factor. You can say, keep swans, keep Miz Maharaj, keep some space for automatically. It's an automatic factor. So, Ekalabya actually is his procedure. If we follow, maybe I can come out successful regarding collecting money, this, that, I can make, you know, 100 temples all over the world. But who can say who is following Gurudev? That is the main problem. External, this kind of, you know, documents is not sufficient, you know, is not sufficient, you know, evidence. Is external matters. So what is the internal matter? You cannot speak Harikatha if you are not growing Trinadavi Bhava. Prabhupada already told. He can speak Harikatha who is totally established in Trinadavi Sloka. Without getting establishment in Trinadavi Sloka, somebody can speak nice Harikatha, it is all, you know, is all gossip. Useless. It cannot so happen. Maybe it is dry philosophy. Maybe it is dry philosophy. It's not possible. Harikatha means, after hearing, you can feel some reaction inside your heart. But most of the people, they like to get enjoyment out of Harikatha. They are so bad luck, they want to use this Harikatha as an entertainment. I already told, when I was bound to go through one writings by a poet, poem, here it is written that writer expecting that Purnima, on Purnim day, Sharat Purnima, or, you know, Maghi Purnima, or, you know, this kind of, when there is full moon in the sky, then we can feel from heart what kind of enjoyment, huh? We can look at the moon and think about Gaur Chandra, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, this, that. But that material writer, he is writing, I can get this, you know, this full moon in the sky, if I can get as a burning, you know, bread, jhalsan ruti mean bread. I like to get bread instead of that full moon in the sky. What use that? So idiot that writer. You see, he is writing. It would have been very good, you know, that if this full moon, if I can get one big bread, chapati, in a fire, it would have been very good. Because I could give this, you know, piece of bread to some poor people, to stop their hungry, you know, attitude, hungriness. So this is the material condition. This is the condition. So Ekalabya, you see, wanted to follow his own track, but Prabhupada speaking, I am not giving the example. In this Gauriya Vaishnava society, if we follow this track, meaning what Guru Vaishnava like, what is concerned to me? I can follow my own track. Maybe I can come out successful with some material success. That doesn't mean that it is improvement or success in Hari Bhajan. It doesn't mean that it is success in Hari Bhajan. So, if we can find all the Siddhanta Vichara of Guru Vaishnava in applied form, if we can see in the life of some devotee, then be sure he is enjoying full kippa of Gurudev. Material people, whole world is so foolish, they cannot understand this point. They misunderstand. If you can find all Siddhanta Vichara, everything in total, or in applied form, in the life of one disciple, then be sure he is snigdho. Actually, we become angry when we hear, you know, very heavy harikatha. We become angry. Why? We have some weakness inside our mind. Guru Vaishnava not going to criticize anybody, but they think they are criticizing me. It's quite natural. I can give one example. That one day is Srila Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami was speaking Harikatha in Calcutta Mall, long ago, 35 years back, maybe. Evening time. And in Harikatha, when Maharaj speaking, one lady became very angry. She get up and speaking in front of public, I know, for me you are speaking. I know you are criticizing me. Maharaj speaking, I don't understand why she is become very angry. I have no, you know, relation with that lady. But the lady is shouting, I know, for me you are speaking like that. Bhaman Goswami Maharaj used to say in Bengali. In Harikatha, if we are speaking Harikatha, if some weakness is there in somebody, if that Harikatha is going to hit that heart, then he become very angry. He think Maharaj is going to criticize me. He cannot think that it is Siddhanta. It is Siddhanta Vichara. So if we have some weakness, we can think Maharaj speaking for me. That way Maharaj not speaking for you automatically. This is the main problem. Also, I was bound to speak that day, we should understand the mood of that Pativrata Ramani. I mean the chaste lady. What is the mood of that chaste lady? How she wanted to satisfy husband? In Vedic culture, it is the rules that if authentic marriage, not that according to your whimsical allergy you can marry some lady, I am not speaking. But as per Vedic culture, Vedic rules, as per Varnasrama Dharma, if actual marriage is done, following actual rules and regulation, then what is the meaning of that marriage, you know? Vast meaning. So Pativrata Ramani should serve husband as a representative or not representative. She should think that I am going to serve Janardhan, Bhagavan, in the form of my husband. In the form of my husband, I am going to serve Janardhan, Supreme Lord. If she is successful to serve that way, then she is called chaste lady, Pativrata. Like Gandhari, like Draupadi, you know. This way, you can find. So, this Pativrata Ramani, Mahaprabhu wanted to give this example, because this is very vital point in the way of Krishna Bhajan. Moral character, ethical, you know, mood, nothing is so important like your love for Krishna. That's why in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Krishna bhajane sneho seva matro apiksha. It is Bengali. Only your deep feeling, a deep love, you know, sneho seva matro apiksha. Sneho seva. You are doing this seva, you know, with full love or not. Extreme love. You are doing this seva or not. Or as a duty you are doing. So, Krishna bhajane sneho seva matro apiksha. Only Krishna waiting to see your heart which is fully melted by devotion and love. Because you want to find the way how you can satisfy Krishna. You try to understand the mood of Radharani. Radharani always in trouble, always countless problems coming, countless. Jotila, Kutila, all senior and a person in the society, all the time Radharani in trouble. They like to find fault with Radharani, they don't like to allow Radharani to serve Krishna. But somehow Radharani want to serve Krishna all the time, very tactfully. Even Radharani want to cheat Jatila, Kutila, husband, everybody. She like to serve Bhagavan Sri Krishna. All the time like to satisfy Krishna. That's why Radharani always playing some trick so that she can serve Krishna all the time. So now what is the mood of that Pratibrata Ramani, I should understand. And when I am speaking about husband, you should not put another question that why Maharaj, and because that, you know, that husband of Radharani is there staying in, you know, no! Ayan Ghosh is not at all husband. In eternal world, there is no existence of Abhimanyu. His name is Abhimanyu. Prabhupada explained this word. Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu is always full of anxiety and angry attitude. Because Kama is there, Hiranyakashipu is always full of angry attitude. Because some Kama is there. If there is no Kama, how is possible that you become angry? Not possible. So Abhimanyu is not the actual husband. I know you can put this question. Just now you told Patibrata Ramani, our husband is Krishna. Especially for Radharani, if I am going to discuss this point, you should understand there is no existence of Abhimanyu, Jatila Kutila, Kansa in the eternal world. Only in this material world to get the charming Leela. Because if there is some struggle in your life to do Krishna Bhajan, then you can get more and more power in your life. But the point is that you like to secure, find some security of your life. But in bhajan life, there is only security that we like to do bhajan. Our devotion is our security. You know, follow, nothing else. Nothing else. In the life of Ramanuja Jyoti, they wanted to kill. Prabhupada, in the life of Prabhupada, you can find so many people wanted to kill Prabhupada because he is speaking all about that absolute truth. So, Patibrata Ramani is serving his husband with a mood that he is going to serve Vaikunthapati. But when I speak about Radharani, Krishna is already there, who is the husband of all infinity Jivatma. And that marriage is false marriage, not actual. Parokhiya bhave to give the bumper success, you know, of parokhiya rasa. And when one river, Jamuna, Ganga, coming from a hilly place, there's so many obstacles there. The more obstacle coming in your life, the more your force can increase. So you can run non-stop. You have to run. If there is any impediments, then you can jump from there. You know. So in the way of Krishna Bhajan, I can discuss next Harikatha. In the way of Hari Bhajan, our moral character, ethical mood, everything, all very cheap thing. Only the thing is very important is our devotional mood. Exclusive devotional mood, love for Krishna. So this Patibrata Ramani, this chaste lady, she want to serve husband, even husband is speaking such a rubbish thing, but still that chaste lady not going to find any fault with husband. Okay. If I can give full satisfaction, anyhow, I can arrange. This way, she was bound to go to serve that cross. Because if that cross is satisfied, she can come in front of husband, I can bring husband in front of that cross. That is the mood. That is the exclusive mood, secret mood of those who are Gaudiya devotees. You can find this mood with Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, or Guru Bhargava, Keshav Goswami, all their life. They are always going to find the satisfaction of Krishna somehow. If externally you can find, no, it is not legal. Hare Maharaj, what is legal, what is not legal? Or everything coming from Krishna. Everything coming from Krishna, what is legal, what is not legal, that is, you know, that's why Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Mannimitta kritam papam dharmaya kalpati. If somebody is going to do some sinful activities for me, but still, is dharma. So dharma and adharma, all everything is, you know, some apparent conception. What is dharma at present, then tomorrow you can change the definition of dharma. But Bhagavad dharma, not changeable. Eternally present, so we cannot apply this formula in the, you know, in the material world. If we live in this material world, we will have to always think about this Bhagavad dharma, not about this, you know, Samaj dharma, Loko dharma, Sarir dharma. We are less interested about that. Dharmam bhajasya satatam tejo loko dharman sevasya sadupurushan johikam trishnan. Who told? Gokarnaji Maharaj told in front of his father Atmadev. Follow. Dharmam bhajasya satatam tejo loko dharman. Apparent dharma, lok dharma, samaj dharma, body related dharma, society related dharma, ethical dharma, all so many things you can find. Samaj dharma, you know, sansar dharma, all different kind of thing. But main point is that what Gokarna wanted to speak in front of father, dharmam bhajasya satatam, continuously uninterrupted way. Dharmam bhajasya satatam tvajo tvajo loka dharman. You should discard all, you know, general phenomena of dharma. No, which is not useful. That is why Jodu Vamsa, from there Jodu Vamsa came. Na, Jodu was given wide acclamation. Why Jodu is getting so much honor in Bhagavatam, you know? Whereas we find Jodu going to ignore his father Jajati, and Puru, the younger son, going to obey father. Pita dharma pita sarga, sarga the vigariyasi. They are speaking from Veda, foolish. They don't understand the inner meaning of Veda. Pita sarga pita dharma, to serve father is everything. But not that. You don't understand this meaning. So, it is written in Bhagavatam that Jodu is the topmost, you know, Bhagavad Dharma Bhakta, in the way of Bhagavad Dharma. In the way of Bhagavad Dharma, we can find Jodhu is a great devotee. Why? Whereas we find externally, Jodhu wanted to ignore Father Jajati, but still he is giving big honor in Bhagavatam. Jodhuscha Nitaram Dharma Silascha, it is written in Bhagavatam, 10th canto. Because he wanted to maintain his Bhagavad Dharma, Seva. If Jodhu going to take the old age of father, Jodhu calculating, if I am going to take the old age of my father, as he is requesting me to take, but he is not going to do bhajan. He want to enjoy his life. Whereas if I give my young age to him, he can enjoy, and I cannot do Krishna bhajan. Big problem. That's why Jodhu wanted to ignore his father to maintain his Bhagavad Dharma Seva, Bhagavad Seva. That is why Jodhu. And Gokarnaji Maharaj speaking to Atmadevji and speaking strict instruction, Dharmam Bhajasya Satatam, uninterrupted way you will have to serve Dharma. What Dharma? Bhagavad Dharma. Dharmam Bhajasya Satatam and Tayo Loka Dharman. You will have to discard, you have to live off. Tayo Loka Dharman. And Sevasya Sadhupurushan Jahi Kama Tishna. You have to serve Sadhuguru Vishnu from heart and discard all your, you know, eliminate all your desire, different kind of annavilas you will have to. But I know why you are not getting result in Harikatha, 100% result you are not getting. Because you are going to get satsanga, at the same time you are going to get some asatsanga, both you are getting. Directly or indirectly, anyhow, you are going to maintain both satsanga, asatsanga. Both you are going to maintain. That's why you are not going to get result. If you like to do satsanga from heart 100%, then if you are doing satsanga, mean you understand what is satsanga, you realize what is satsanga, so automatically it's an automatic factor. You cannot go for a satsanga. You can get some sensitivity inside your heart. Automatically you can grow some sensitivity in your heart after hearing Harikatha for a long time. You can hear, you can understand. You can feel some sensitivity inside you. If you hear anybody, oh, it is material speech. It is not Arul Bhagavad Katha. You can arrest, but you cannot understand. You try to make compromise. Okay, they are also Vaishnav. They are also, okay, they are also Vaishnav. Who is going to fight with them? But if you want to do Hari Bhajan, you will have to do only satsanga. In your whole life, you will have to do satsanga, then you can come out successful. If you are ready to deliver another bonded soul, you are yourself in bonded stage, then you cannot deliver. Because a drowning man catches at a straw. A man going to die in water, you want to help him, whereas you don't know how to swim. If you yourself don't know how to swim, if you are going to help that man, bonded soul, they are so in a weak position that their resistivity is so weak that any time if they come in front of the bonded soul, they are bound to accept something from them. But what is the mood of Prabhupada? Whereas Prabhupada acting as that chastity lady, what is the mood of that Prabhupada? What is the mood of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava? Prabhupada clearly discussed this point. We are going to invite all important personalities from this society. As the chairman of the Sabha, chairman, you know, main spokesman, this. But Prabhupada giving instruction, we are surely going to invite them because some great impact we can see in the society. But that doesn't mean we will have to accept something from them. They are bonded soul. Actually, Prabhupada is not going to invite them to speak Harikatha. Prabhupada is going to invite those important personalities from the society to allow them to hear about their absolute truth. But externally, you can find Maharaj, you know, calling that scientist, Maharaj going to, Madhu Goswami going to invite that governor of Bengal, this, that. Why? Because they are acting as chasty lady. Prabhupada speaking, surely we are not going to accept anything from them. But we are going to show honor to them simply because we can get some extra advantage in our preaching field. If I am going to get some extra facility in Hari Bhajan, then I can show some respect to somebody. That I can do. That is called, that is why it is very secret, you know, vichar, siddhanta vichar, that all nice, you know, those who are elevated devotees in Gauriya society, Gauriya Mat, they are like their chastity lady. They are not going to think anything about themselves. Always they are going to follow this mood, how to satisfy Krishna. If some important personality coming, then some, those who are arrogant, they can say, oh, in Gauriya Mat, this 1 month symposium, oh, that, you know, very, very important personalities in this world, in this society, they are coming. So let us go and see what is happening there. This way they can have the chance to hear Harikatha from them. That is why, that is the secrecy of Hari Bhajan. Like Patibrata Rami Chasti Lady. We will have to maintain this secrecy. We can do our Hari Bhajan according to this procedure, so that externally you can find some problem with me. You can indicate that Maharaj is not doing legal, you know, Maharaj is not going to adopt legal procedure. But what is legal, what is illegal? I like to think about Krishna Seva. But if you like to misuse this point, then for infinity period you can go to hell. You cannot misuse this point. Everybody cannot speak this word. Everybody, now at present, if somebody were Maharaj, we are also falling. No, it's not possible. They are busy with their love, puja, patishtha. They cannot use this point. This point is applicable for those dedicated souls, big sadhus, for them. Now, I like to go back to this, my original discussion of Vishva Vaishnava Prasava. There is some different division, vibhag. Their first day, that day I was speaking, Manod Mandali. They are always searching and looking whom to give big honor. Whom to give. You know, they are watching. Those who are going to give nice service, very nice throughout the year, very nice service. All the time they are serving. So according to their service, Prabhupada watching from heart, and at the time of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava, then Prabhupada want to confer, give some title to some devotees. That is, so this way, this was the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that time also. That is why we find different kind of titles and the different parsads of Mahaprabhu we can find. And different kind of titles they are enjoying. And on behalf of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava, it was the duty of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava to confer, to give them some title according to their nice activities. They are doing some nice seva. So, sometime Vidya Vinod, sometime, you know, Para Vidya Bhushan, different kind of, you know, title that Prabhupada used to give. And if they are going to accept that honor from their heart, then automatically they can get contaminated. Because in that case it is not at all Vaishnavi Pratishtha. Prabhupada not going to give any material pratishtha to you and me. Prabhupada wanted to give Vaishnavi Pratishtha so that you can get alert. Sir, Prabhupada giving me Pada Vidya Bhushan. So I must be very careful. This title is not at all applicable for me. It is the highness of Prabhupada that you want to give me this title. That's mean Prabhupada going to give indication that you will have to, you know, to attain this quality. Sometime in Sabha, I was bound to speak some something. But they think Maharaj speaking mean Maharaj giving honor to us. When I am speaking, they are thinking that Maharaj giving us honor. They don't know that I am speaking this way because you will have to attain this position. You will have to attain that stage. Not that you already get. This should be the mood. So, Vaishnavi Pratishtha Tate Karanishtha Tahana Kuri Raviwe Rura. Prabhupada wanted to give this Vaishnavi Pratishtha if some Para Vidya Bhushan or some Vidya Vinod cannot digest the, you know, this kind of honor given by Prabhupada, they are surely going to fall down. So what he can do? If Guru Vaishnava is going to give us honor, we should think Maharaj is going to give us Vaishnavi Pratishtha. So this way I can accept, but not material way. So Vaishnavi Pratishtha Tate Karo Nishtha Tahana Kuri Raviver Ura. So this way, first Vishwa Vaishnava Rasabha was, you know, again re-established at the Avirbhav Tithi of Vishnupriya Devi, 4th February in the year of 1919 in Bhaktivinoda Ashram, number 1, Ultradingi Junction in North Calcutta. After that Prabhupada, you know, went on doing this procedure. You know, this procedure. Vishwabhishna. Every year, Prabhupada used to arrange at the Gaur Avirbhav Tithi, because that time all people from different corners of the world can come. That's why Prabhupada used to arrange it. So, Mananda Mandali means it is a division. They are divisional activities. Those who are watching, whom to give right honor. So we are actually habituated to get false honor. We are habituated. So we cannot digest. So, again, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prachar Mandali. There is one, another, you know, Mandali group. Those who are busy with Prachar of the Vishuddha cult, Vaishnava cult, I mean. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Shiksha, Achar Adarsho, and they are busy with this, you know, Prachar. They are always. So first, there is one also subdivision. First is Nam Prachar Sakha. They are all Nam Prachar Sakha mean, they are like under the guidance of Nityananda Prabhu, Namahatta, in very nicely or under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava like Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, under the guidance of them, some devotee going to speak Harikatha here and there, do Kirtan, Nagar Sankirtan also within this category. Nam Prachar Sakha, this is called Nam Prachar Sakha. Different kind of function should be arranged. Pure. There should not be any political motive. With pure heart, we should arrange Bhagavad Katha, Harikatha, Kirtan, everything, all the time. But there should not be any political mood. My disciple, is totally material person. He is idiot number one. He is going to recite Bhagavatam. And Guruji thinking, I cannot recite Bhagavatam. At least my disciple can recite Bhagavatam. Then thousands of people can hear. They can ask, who is the Gurudev? Because foolish people, they don't understand what is Harikatha, what is no. Many time I protest, you should not allow him to speak Harikatha, Bhagavad Katha. Who permit you, even directly to that disciple, who permit you to speak Harikatha? This way, he is speaking, my Gurudev told. And then after that, that disciple is going to provide a big kick in the chest of Gurudev and gone. Because Gurudev is material and disciple is also material. If there is shortage of any facility and honor, is going to throw Gurudev. Follow? This is the condition of Guru Shishya. If there is some shortage of honor, personal facility, then they can throw Gurudev. If you are also going to accept Gurudev with this mood, then you can also live, no problem. So, Nagar Ishtagasthi, Harikatha, different kind of Harikatha, Pravachan, Nagar Sankirtan, all within this category. It is called Nam Prachar Sakha. Another sub-sakha of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prachar Mandali, this is first sub-heading, sub-sakha, I mean group. Second subdivision is Shastra Prachar Sakha, but Shastra Vichar Sakha. So there cannot have any chance for any material people in the guise of sannyasi. They can speak all rubbish. They are not going to speak any Shastra Siddhanta, nothing. So we will have to stop it. How? Under the guidance of Prabhupada, all our Guru Varga going and preaching, sometimes they are speaking in such a way that you can go mad. Siddha Sarup Prabhu who is actually Siddhanti Maharaj. Siddhanti Maharaj one day in open Calcutta, in open big, you know, Dharma Sabha, speaking about one society. They are actually hooligan. They are actually hooligan, gunda. They are not spiritual figure. There is big evolution. See, Santokus Sila Kesakusi Maharaj speaking. They are all leather man. They are all leather man in front of whom I can speak Harikatha. Then big agitation started. This is our Guru Varga like lion, you see. All our Guru Varga like lion, they don't care. If somebody come to fight, they are speaking all wrong Siddhanta in front of public to get, you know, some boat, you know. They are always going to speak all rubbish Siddhanta, which are everything, like Sahaja, to get boat, you know, popularity. That's why they are doing. So what is the duty of Vishwa Vaishnava Raja Sabha? If there is thousands of Sabha, you know, then which Sabha is in the line of Vishwa Vaishnava Sabha, you will have to understand. That is where, without any political motive, Prabhupada was bound to speak, you cannot go anywhere and everywhere. Somebody wanted to took permission from me, Maharaj, in Vrindavan, we like to go and hear Harikatha from that Maharaj. I say, okay, you can go. But you don't have that much capacity to digest. Because they are not going to love Gauriya Mada, I know. I can touch Gita in front of those Maharaj. I can touch Gita and say they don't love Gauriya Mada. Big speaker. Sometimes they are quoting the words of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But they are against Gauriya Mada. Never in their dream also, they never want to quote any quotation of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. They can give quotation from countless, you know, dirty fields. They can give countless, their Harikatha, you can go through their Harikatha, you can find that if they are going to speak 2 hours, out of that, they are speaking 1 hour 50 minutes, 1 hour 30 minutes, all rubbish. All different kind of, you know, bhaktamal. Bhaktamal means different kind of example from different sadhu, all material sadhus. Maybe they have some little siddhi, this, that. They never in dream. You can show me one speaker in Vrindavan. Those who are going to earn name and fame as a nice speaker. You can show me. Never they are going to quote from Bhaktivinoda Thakura Prabhupada. They are against Gauriya Math. They are against Gauriya Math. This way, first of all, you will have to detect. If you are going to love Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakura, you cannot expect any Harikatha. You cannot expect any Harikatha without any topics of Bhaktivinoda Thakura and Prabhupada. Because without the topic of Bhaktivinoda Thakura and Prabhupada, any Maharaj speaking anything, all rubbish. No, it has got no, you know, no importance. So I told them, you can go and hear Harikatha, but I cannot take any risks. Because I am sure that you are not going to hear anything about Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakura. But I know, he is not speaking Siddhanta Virod. He is speaking Siddhanta a little bit. Okay. But never going to touch the topics of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakura. At all, sometimes quoting something from Jayavadhanama, this, that, but not with full faith. That is the main point. I know them. So this way, Prabhupada used to speak, you cannot go anywhere and everywhere. You cannot go. Where you can get the scope to hear all about pure Gauriya philosophy, I mean, Saraswat Gauriya Darshan, if you can have the scope, surely you can go. Srila Bharati Maharaj used to speak. Srila Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Goswami Maharaj used to speak. All you can go there. They have. So all speaking all rubbish, no Siddhanta, nothing, they can run here and there. You have to understand this point. So, to stop mispitching, today our formula is there. Today our formula, we are going to adopt this formula, Tumbichu Bhambichu. Tumbichu Bhambichu, you know this meaning. Are Maharaj, this Maharaj speaking, they, oh, let him speak, what it concerns to, I'm going to speak. Tumbichu Bhambichu. One Maharaj going to foreign country, he told that Maharaj is preaching going with this style. One Maharaj coming, speaking something, after the another Maharaj coming, he is not going to touch this sensitive issue. Because if touch, big fighting can take place, I cannot get any pranami. Main target is to get pranami. Ah, let him see. Ah, everybody okay. You should be Vaishnava, you should not speak. But I know Srila Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Goswami used to fight. No, I cannot stay here. Why? Because they have some exclusive mood of pure devotion. Everybody cannot follow this. They have some weak point. Oh, let them speak that way. Ah, okay. That Tumbichu Bhambichu, Prabhupada speaking. Prabhupada speaking, at present we are in favor of this point. We are going to adopt this procedure, Tumbichu Hambichu. Are Maharaj, you don't criticize us. Let us do what I... And we are also not going... Some group came in front of Prabhupada and speaking, you should know, you can speak Harikatha. You can speak Harikatha, but you should not speak anything about us. In front of... You can speak your own Harikatha. You can speak your own Harikatha, but don't touch this sensitive issue. What is happening here and there? Why not? They are speaking to Prabhupada. Because they never like to rectify themselves. They never like to rectify themselves. They like to follow the same procedure. They want this kind of corrupted procedure persist in their life. They like. That's why. So, Sastra Prachar Sakha is very important. So, not that everybody can go in the market and start speaking Harikatha. First point, who told you? Who told you to speak Harikatha? Who is going to give you order? to speak Harikatha. Because without any order, if somebody starts speaking, it's not good. It's not authentic Harikatha. So you see, also regarding Anubad, translation, it's very important issue. Very important issue. Those who are not enjoying full Guru Vaishnava Kipa, they cannot make translation properly. They know language very much. Their education is very high. Very high. But they cannot understand the mood of Guru Vaishnava. That's why they cannot translate properly. Big problem. So translation is not a matter of joke. So everybody can do, not that. So actually, those who are Sabar Raja, so according to the order of Jiva Goswami Pad, all our Guru Varga going to preach, protect Sasya Siddhanta, they are going to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani, so that nobody can make a distorted form of that darshan. Nobody. Full protection. That is the main duty of Vishwa Vaishnava Raja Sabha. And in Namahatta, they cannot allow any garbage to come and contaminate. So always, virus, bacteria, it should be sterilized. Full sterilization should be done. There cannot be any contamination. If at all any contamination, then catch and throw outside. By at present, Tumbichu, Bhambichu. Hare, let him speak. I am also speaking. We are Vaishnava, we should not criticize. Hare, Maharaj, this is not criticism. There is a question of your sampradaya. You are going to sell your sampradaya for a little pratishtha and money pratishtha. You are going to sell your sampradaya like Mirjafar. This is your condition. So, Sasto Prachar Sakha, this is one. So, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prachar Mandali, within that first subheading, Nam Prachar Sakha. Second, I speak Shastra Prachar Sakha. We will have to protect all Siddhanta, which are everything. And we should publish different books and magazines containing all Siddhanta, which are perfect. Oh, after Prabhupada gone, different people writing all rubbish. Follow. All different magazine you can go through, they are all rubbish. All important man. Mara, they are giving order. Acharya, you can write something. Hare Maharaj, through your magazine you want to do some seva. But you think it is a matter of joking. That man going to give you financial support, so you want to. You can also write one magazine in Gaur Purnima for idiot number one. He is a material person. He is going to write something. Only I find the magazine, only. At present I find one magazine is going to maintain some standards still today. That is Devananda Gorimath Bengali magazine. Still today, they are trying to maintain some quality. All other magazine, no. They can speak something. Even if they are going to quote something, Prabhupada, but they are not going to quote, they are going to quote, some or certain point which is not going against them. They can say, we are also publishing some writings of Prabhupada, but they are going to publish, but such portion, which is not going against them. This way. So also that, Shastra Sikha Sakha. There is another subheading, Shastra Sikha Sakha, where is the main important thing, is a very important thing, that regularly those who are novice, those who are coming new, we should not, you should not give some lucrative offer to him. In my life also, I was fighting with them. One Maharaj coming from foreign country, now I am going to maintain mat somehow by the mercy of Gurudev. For some reason, I was bound to do that. I was given order. I find that Maharaj coming from foreign, what preaching he has done, he knows. He is going to give some money to one very small devotee. Hey, I can give you 50 rupees. You wash my clothes and everything. He is washing and getting 50 rupees. I was so angry, so angry. I was bound to charge that Maharaj, you are foolish number one. Automatically you can get some seva from them. Why you are going to break rules and regulation? That Maharaj giving order, that giving order to a small brahmachari. You can take some chapati and milk and give into the room of that Mataji. She coming with him from foreign country. I giving strict order, not at all. That brahmachari cannot go to her room. She can come and take. Then break agitation started against me. This way all the time, fighting took place. So what to do? So all the time, you will have to, you know, you will have to arrange situation in such a way, because those who are new devotee, if they are not giving feasible condition, positive, they have that kind of power they don't have. They can break their mood. Somebody is speaking, Maharaj, those who are coming, okay, even if negative position, they can stay. No. If you like to increase the number of small devotees, you will have to arrange situation in such a way, you will have to eliminate negative situation, so that at least they can get some power. Not that everything can, it is a, you know, if those great devotees, they are going to ignore. You cannot change their mood. Those are novice. For them, you will have to speak all about Gaudiya teachings. Not that you are going to make separate teachings. Then you are going to break the Siddhanta of Prabhupada. Prabhupada giving order that you should arrange so that new devotees can get inspiration to learn some new things. And in every year, there was the arrangement of Bhakti Shastri Pariksha. All devotees, they should learn Shastra through Ishtagoshti and everything. Not that they can eat and sleep. They should learn under the guidance of pure Guru Vishnu. Not that we can put them in darkness. This is the present system. They can make hundreds of devotees, but they like to put them in darkness. It is good for them. So, actually point is that every year Mahaprabhu Janmosav, at the time of Abhirbhav Tithi of Mahaprabhu, and at the Abhirbhav Tithi of Bhakti Vinod, at present only at the every year, one time, as Mahasivan Mahapu Abhirbhav Utsav at present. Previously it was two times. You know, Bhakti Vinod Abhirbhav Kal, half yearly and annually, actually at the time of Gaurapurnim. Bhakti Shastri Parikha Pavartan. Different kind of question and answer. All novice devotees should appear in the exam. If they are going to get mark, which is above minimum level, then they are going to get some honor with some degree like Bhakti Shastri, this, that. That time it was very important. At present, somebody can pay 10,000 rupees to some pandit in Navadvip. They can get one certificate very easy. But that time it was not so easy. At the time of Prabhupada, it was very tough. So, you will have to appear in exam. If you can pass, come out successful, then Bhakti Shastri Pariksha Pavartan, in that case, he can be given this order, Shastri, or, you know, different kind of exam degrees. So, now, it is almost rare. So, day by day, we are going to lose. We are going to get deviated from the track of Prabhupada. How far we are deviated from Prabhupada? we'll have to calculate to discover the present painful situation. And Jigyasa Mandali, here is very important group. It is called, one group is there, they are always busy with interrogation, scrutiny. They like to scrutiny. They like to do scrutiny. What is going on actually? Like examiner, guy coming now. Examiner sometime coming to pay his honor, you know, visit to school and colleges. So, this way actually, Jigyasa Mandali, they are always doing scrutiny. They are getting close eyes. They are going to keep close eyes on what all other activities going on. If they find some newcomer, they are going to put some question in him. In my life also, so many people used to come. I used to put them question. After question and answer, then I could realize the reason for why they are coming. So now any people come, okay, you can come and take prasadam, you must stay and we can make you a hooligan. Very good. This is a system. But Jigyasa Mandali means they are always with inquiry. Hey, what you are doing? Why you are doing? Why you have come here? Eh? All the time there is some inquiry. So it was the system that time. So you have no right to do anything what you like. Any devotee is going to do something which is not usual, then you know those Jigyasa Mandali can ask, why you are doing this? At the time of Sanatan Rupa Goswami, this Mandali was so strong that any devotee in the society in Vrindavan here there, they are doing any rubbish thing, then he will have to give answer in front of those sabha. Why you have done such a wrong activities that for that whole society and outside people can criticize the whole society? Why you have done this regarding some woman case or anything, wrong siddhanta or anything? So at present, no problem. He is doing all rubbish, but still, okay, let him do his own job. So, Vishwa-Vishnu-Vrasava, the activities of Vishwa are totally failure at present. Totally failure. So, at that time, it was the special duty of those, you know, group to keep close watch on the activities and character of them, Sangha. What for you have come to take Diksha? Why you can take Harinam? Why? What is your mood? But now nobody going to put question. That is why garbage always increasing. Garbage increasing, that is why. And the fourth subheading is that Pashanda Dalan Mandali. There is some group, the very powerful, like soldier, reserve soldier. They can crush the head of those demonic character people. Pashanda Dalan Mandali is reserve force. Prabhupada used to send them to break the head of those demonic character people, demonic people. You have to give, at the time of Prabhupada, you can go through Gauri, everything. So many outside people passing this kind of remark, then Gauri society, Gauri are not going to give result, give answer, fitting answer. Going to give fitting answer. Up to Keshav Goswami Maharaj and Bhaman Goswami Maharaj also, it was almost successful. Pashanda Dalan. Any people, any writer, any Maharaj, writing all rubbish, we should give fitting answer to him. So, this is called protest note. Sometime in front of Sabha, we have seen Santo Goswami Maharaj sitting in Sabha as a he called one big, you know, philosopher, Pandit. He's sitting in Sabha, he's speaking all about Mayavad Siddhanta. He's speaking and Maharaj watching. not speaking anything. After the sabha is over, then Maharaj started giving answer. And that man Mayavadi sitting just, you know, just near Srila Santa Goswami Maharaj. Maharaj taking a stick, you know, and going to beat that man. Amarna, why you are beating me? Maharaj going to beat him. Not actually, false. Then the man become very afraid. Then Maharaj speaking in front of Sabha. You just told me there is other, you know, you are actually Advaitavadi. Eh? Now you are going to fear me. That's when you are not established in this tattva. Eh? Why you are fearing? Except Brahma, there is nothing. So I am also Brahma, you are also Brahma. Why you are fearing? Then the man was, you know, insulted that way. So now nobody is speaking. Oh, let him speak. At the time of Prabhupada, at the time of Kesava Goswami Maharaj, they used to give fitting answer. So you have to, anybody writing or Ravi Shekhar's Gauri, big writer, famous, on behalf of Gauri Mart, protest note was there. There was a big case on behalf of Gauri Mart against him. He wanted to insult Gauri Mart. Then ultimately he was defeated. In open sabha, in court, he was bound to confess his mistake. Yeah, all rubbish against Prabhupada, Pukasana, all same. All rubbish they are speaking. Rubbish Siddhanta. But everybody going to hear it. Nobody there to protest. If at all somebody, some Maharaj going to protest by the order of Guru Vaishnava, I was bound to write so many things because on behalf of Saraswat Gauri Sangha, they give me order. But some Maharaj criticizing. Yes, he is not going to do bhajan. He is always busy with this, that. Hari Maharaj, this is bhajan. To give fitting answer. You don't understand. Eh? So this is called Pasando Dalan Mandali. If somebody is speaking Mayavad, if somebody is speaking anything against Gauri Mart, we will have to crush down their head. This is called, if at all genuine Siddhanta, Vastav Saddha, Bhagavad Dharma, eternally Bhagavad Dharma is somehow attacked, if somehow going to be attacked by somebody, we will have to give fitting answer to them, we will stop their hands, set up in the form of Harikatha, in the form of, like I can give you example, Prabhupada was sent by Bhaktivinoda Thakur to Baligai. Prabhupada was sent by Bhaktivinoda Thakur to Baligai to give fitting answer to the idiot Brahman Vaishnav Sabha. This way, each and every time we have the, but who is going to follow whom? Who is going to follow whom at present situation is that who is going to follow whom? Nobody like to give honor to any. In Rabindranath Tagore writing in his, Amra Sabai Raja Amaderi Raja Rajatri in Bengali. Rabindranath Tagore writing. We are all king in our this kingdom. Amra Sabai Raja Amaderi Raja Rajatri. We are all king in the kingdom of this king. So what can be the situation? If at all, if you have any etiquette, acharan, bhajan pa, still nobody going to give honor to you. Of course, they are also not going to get any honor from anybody. But they have that kind of spirit they don't have. The negative spirit. They can say that Maharaj having destructive attitude. They are speaking that Maharaj having some destructive attitude, always speaking this way. Eh? What do you mean by destructive attitude? To give the full protection of Siddhanta Bhani is called destructive attitude. Follow, this is their Siddhanta, foolish number one. So you will have to publish different books and magazines and everything, protest note, sparikatha, against any criticism, you will have to give answer. So now another branches is called Utsav Mandali. Utsav Mandali, you will have to arrange different kind of function. at the Abhirbhav Tithi and Tirabhav Tithi of Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan, that is called Usav Mandali. They have their duty to arrange Abhirbhav Tithi, Tirabhav Tithi and arrange function in such a way that there's those who are coming in this function, they can have the scope to hear perfect Harikatha. Not that I have money power, I can arrange some rasagulla, sweet ball and this, that, everything and give pranami 500 rupees or 1000 rupees. This is not bandara. This is not, at present it is all distorted. Conception is totally changed. Usab Mandali, this group is always busy to give full protection, full honor to this Utsav. Not that only eating and sleeping and going, taking pranami. At present situation. So you will have to take the responsibility on behalf of Rasa Vaishnava Rastava. Show that this Abhirbhav Tithi or Bhaktivinoda Thakur or Abhirbhav Tithi Prabhupada, you can go and see the situation at present. I feel sorry, I don't like to go anymore. They don't like to discuss Harikatha. Only they like to Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada. After that, hey, arrange, time is over, arrange prasadam. This is the bandara. But the main function of Utsav Mandali, the group, those who are responsible for this kind of, you know, those arranging Utsav and function different, the main duty that to arrange Harikatha Kirtan from the lotus feet of pure Guru Vishnu, so that those who are going to attend this function, they can get some, there is some chitbal. They are going to get some chitbal power. So this way, actually, every time we have some group, you know, Bhakti Anushthan Machajyananut, then also different kind of function of devotional function. Like parikrama, these that you will have to, but under the guidance of pure Guru, you have no right to follow your own fanciful mind. You cannot do. Maybe in the name of parikram, you can collect lakhs of rupees. You can spend something. Suppose you collect 40 lakhs, you spend 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs. This way, we should not do business. If we collect anything from what seva, we should promise that I can spend this money for this seva. Not that in the name of this seva I can collect and use it for, not that. You know, this way. Or at all, if there is any divine, you know, scope to use, like in the case of Bhakti Dvaita Madhu Goswami Maharaj. Bhakti Dvaita Madhu Goswami Maharaj wanted to make some Natya Mandir. And some devotee from some part of Punjab or some sending some money. That amount of money was there with Narottam Brahmachari, our, you know, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. And Bhakti Vedanta Madhu Goswami speaking, you see, at present we'll have to complete this seva. If you can give this amount and use it, then very shortly we can give you back this money. Because this seva is for. But Bharati Maharaj told, I mean, actually, not going to protest, Gurudev, this devotee going this seva for this reason. Maharaj speaking, okay, we can give this amount back for this seva. So this is exclusive case. For divine purpose, we can do it, not manipulation. This way, different kind of, you know, in different temples, you know, we can go and arrange function, at the establishment, you know, at the installment, you know, installment of deity, Vigraha Patishtha Utsav, different kind of function can be there. But under the strict guidance of Guru Vaishnava, you will have to go and search Gaur Mandal, Gaur Tirtha, where it is almost nobody going to understand. So, Lupta Tirtha Urdhat. Suppose this Lila Kshetra nobody at present knows. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to discover that this place is Gauranga Mahaprabhu used to do this Lila. That place, Gauranga Mahaprabhu used to do this Lila. This is the place where Gauranga Mahaprabhu took birth. This way, under the guidance of all powerful Guru Vaishnav, Acharya, different place, important places you can indicate, I mean discover. You can install different seva in different modes under the guidance of Guru Vaishnav. That is called Bhakti Anushthan Mandali. Bhakti is so delicate thing that if you try to take the help of argument, that devotional life finish. This way, on behalf of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava, after Jiva Goswami Prabhupada, Bhakti Mutha, all, you know, Jiva Goswami Prabhupada was, Rajpatra, very important personality, who used to organize so scientific way. Also, I can discuss someday, next Harikatha, I can also discuss all in details. So, today I like to stop my Harikatha here, time is over actually. So, Kipaya Harikirtana Murti Dharan Dharani Varaharaka Gaurajanam Janakadika Vasala Snigda Padam Panamami Sadapabhu Padu Padam Panamami Sadapabhu Padu Padam Panamami Sadapabhu Padu Padam Vanchakalpaturvasya kipasindu bhavishya patitanam pavana bhavishna bhyo namo namo.